In celebrity plot twist news.
Is this the Kardashians one?
No, but we're talking about that later.
Oh, I'm excited.
Is it the one, the guy that said, hey, something racist happened and it didn't happen?
It is.
Oh my God.
Submitted by Shame On You.
I don't even know who we're talking about. Who?
Empire actor Jussie Smollett.
This mofo, right? He faked all that bullshit?
Hold on. Has been charged for allegedly making a false police report.
I think it's pretty... Cool.
Allegedly, Steve.
Okay, yeah, my bad.
I thought they had the guys and they were like bodybuilders.
Hello.
Let me fill in the people that don't know.
Somebody call me the bat words.
Yeah, fill in the blanks before I make wrong assumptions and then I get in trouble.
Yeah, same. Okay, so Jussie.
That's so fun.
Smollett. To get in trouble.
He's a smelly mullet.
A smollet.
We can say that now.
A smollet? Oh, okay.
We can
smollet?
Say that now.
We can all pile on now.
That's racist.
No, it's not.
Smelly mullet?
You saying he's a stinky Canadian?
Oh, yeah. I didn't know he was a Canadian.
I don't know.
Canadians have mullets?
Yeah, that's what they're known for.
What?
Hockey and mullets.
Oh. I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and smollets. Maple syrup.
Theo Vaughn's not Canadian.
He's Louisianian.
But he has a mullet.
He has a mullet, and it's a smelly mullet.
I think that Mississippi
Silent Mikey.
River, that Mississippi River, it goes from
it traveled south down
to north.
Oh, that could be.
That area creates that mulletness.
That's funny. Okay, so Jussie Smollett. So back in, I'm gonna tell you the entire timeline of what happened.
Ah, Smollett.
So January 22nd, a week before he said that he was attacked, he reported receiving an envelope addressed to him at the production studios in Chicago, and the envelope was postmarked 4 days earlier. Whatever. It had the letters MAGA.
Is it January this year or last year?
This year.
Okay.
So this is
just happened.
This just happened.
Yeah. Very recent.
So it had MAGA written on it in red.
MAGA police.
I forgot about that.
That's so stupid.
That's what it was written in the return address part, okay?
That's a lie because they don't even let you send anything out that doesn't have an address.
Yeah?
No, they do.
Yeah?
Really?
Yeah.
Because at least where
this got received by Fox, though. It was received. The letter was received. It's not like they were like, we put this aside and we're not going to send this shit.
No, because they did that to me.
It falls through the cracks. It happens.
Okay. Yeah, because this
depends
one
on how mean the post office worker is.
Oh, they're fucked.
I think if you walk it to them and hand it to them,
they won't take it.
But this guy didn't do that. He dropped it in like a thing.
Yeah.
He wanted to be anonymous.
True. Yeah, so then there was white powder inside the envelope, but then later it was determined to just be like crushed up Tylenol. January 29th. He reported that he was attacked by two men while he was getting food near his apartment. And so this actor, who is openly gay, and he is obviously African American, let me show you a photo. So he said that these two men walked up to him, yelled racial and homophobic slurs, and then declared, "This is MAGA country." And then hit him, and then wrapped a noose around his neck.
That's mean.
And poured bleach on.
No. I didn't hear that part.
Oh, no, they did that to get to bleach his skin or...
Oh, shit, I didn't read that part.
Was it Clorox?
Fucked up.
I didn't know that one.
If it was true.
So all of this is now his fake story to like...
Well, that's, yes, allegedly.
Allegedly. So now it's allegedly that's his fake story.
Yes. So then...
If it happened.
That's when the Chicago police, they were interviewing a whole bunch of people, like witnesses, and then they were looking through surveillance camera footage. And they found two people that were walking near that street, but they didn't see, the police report that they didn't see the actual attack happen. So, Jussie, he comes out and he does a performance in West Hollywood on February 2nd. And he's just like, you know, saying like, oh, thanks for all the support. I'm not gonna let them win. And he came out on TV a couple times doing these interviews and being like, yeah, you know, just trying to move ahead, right?
Well, he did a cry interview. He did the cry interview.
Yes, he did.
Which, where he was like, I come out real hard against the president, man. I come fucking hard, dude. Like, he's like making it sound like he was, like, that's why this happened to him, is because he goes so hard against Trump, man.
Yeah. He didn't say that.
Oh, so he's saying that he got targeted because he's such a...
Such a badass. He's such a fucking...
Like, he talks so openly.
He speaks his mind. He's one of those guys who just says whatever he thinks, man.
I wonder what side Steve's on.
Everybody says that. Everyone.
Oh, I just think it's hilarious.
Yeah, no, I mean, like, it sounds like you really like this guy.
Yeah, well, yeah. I.
You hate fake shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so then on February 12th.
I hate fake shit too.
I fake hate shit.
It's funny because everyone thinks they're edgelords now by speaking their mind, but it's like, I wish you spoke your mind during my grandpa's time. See what the fuck happened to you then.
I wish you would speak your mind during a time where we would punish you for it.
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah.
Yeah, then it's different. Then it's like you're fighting for the cause.
Now no, you're like, right.
There's no consequence.
Yeah, it's not. There's no consequence.
That, you're not being a badass if there's no consequence.
That's true. Yeah,
that's what Jill was saying when we first heard about this news. Not the the aftermath follow up, but like before, like when he got beat up, she was like, "Well, what about all the other gay dudes that got discriminated against before this guy? You know, like why are we shining so much light on this guy? There's like a ton of dudes that have to face racism and prejudice and get beat up and all that shit. And it's like, why is this guy so special?
Well, that's because he's a celebrity.
A celebrity.
Yeah, and that's what he just did.
With the consequence thing, I think that's why that's the motive for him inventing a consequence.
Yeah.
Like, so it looks like he spoke his mind and he faced a consequence because
I'm the victim.
That's why he's a badass.
But this is so bad because if he did do this,
I know.
You know what it does is it just takes down so many legit activism.
Yeah.
Like, sure. Like it's like the women that want to get.
That's what he said as well. He also said that, like, why would I be making this up? Because then it just sets us back.
Because he's saying that to protect
the mafia
himself.
Would do that.
It's mafia.
Yeah, he's
mafia.
Playing.
Yeah.
You know all the, like, the angry ex-girlfriends that, like, say, like, my boyfriend raped me and all this stuff, and they didn't actually do it? And then now it makes it harder for women to report that, or like now there's got to be all these extra checks because now everyone's looked like in a little microscope, like, oh really, did you really get raped, you know? Like,
yeah,
it's all fucked up. So now with when there's legit activism going on, everyone's gonna look at them like, really, is there really a problem going on?
Yeah
mm-hmm. For sure. So just to wrap it up then, because I was trying to give you guys all the details,
give us more details,
go faster. So anyway, so then he ended up giving police all of his phone records, but not, like, it was a lot of redacted things in it. So police were like, well, this isn't sufficient, like, you know, whatever. But then Jesse said, well, we redacted it because we wanted to protect people that didn't, it was just not relevant to attack. So then that's when police said that they got the two persons of interest, those two brothers, that they got them in for questioning. And it turns out that these brothers, so they're from Nigeria, they used to work on Empire set way back in the day. Or I don't know when, but they did before in the past. And then one of the brothers, he was a personal trainer of Jesse. So like they actually- like,
wait, these two together. Brothers, are they white?
No, yeah, so, they're black.
Because you're saying two white guys beat the fuck out of them, right?
And he said they were wearing MAGA hats, but they couldn't find MAGA hats. They had to just buy red hats because they're in the middle of Chicago. So they just had red hats on in sub fucking 20 degree weather, like fake beating a guy up.
Oh my God.
Oh wait, so he got two of his buddies to fake beat him up?
Well, that's what the
this
cops
is
are
the
saying.
Oh.
Yeah, that's what's happening here. So then the cops released the brothers, and then they charged Jesse with the felony for a false police report. But then Jesse is, his attorney is saying, like, or actually himself, he was just like, well, the Chicago police, they lie a lot. Like, you know, we can't fully believe that they're
lying. Man, that sucks. Yeah.
Why would they lie about this one thing?
Dude, the evidence sucks for him.
Yeah.
Dude, these guys knew him. He called them that night. They had phone records of that. They subpoenaed his phone records.
He deleted it from his phone.
Yeah, and that's how they found out it was those guys. Everything that he deleted was who he used.
Yeah.
So he, dude's fucking
so they have evidence that he was communicating, like, all right, you're gonna wear red hats, you're gonna do this thing, and then we're gonna go viral.
He also sent himself this fucking anthrax, fake anthrax letter that had like a gay slur.
Wow.
Yeah,
so then they also released surrellance footage of these two brothers purchasing the rope that was used in the attack.
Oh my God.
But then people-
So they have like the Home Depot footage or whatever.
Yeah.
And they're buying the rope and then they're like tying it together and they're like, you think this will work?
And they're not even white.
I like how in your story, the camera footage followed them all the way into their house.
No. They're at the register and they're like, you think this will work, bro?
Yeah. Okay, yeah.
Is this good?
Yeah.
People that still have Jesse's back, though, are saying like, hey, well, look at the timestamp of the surveillance footage. It's from yesterday. So that obviously couldn't have happened before the attack. So
that was a different noose they bought for a different thing.
I know. So they're just saying that the people that are
wait what
that is
they're saying
is,
they're saying
they're saying the timestamp on the camera one of the most inaccurate things perhaps in recorded human history.
They bought it for another news thing that they needed. I guess
so they're saying that the cops are planting all this or like faking it. Like the people that are supporting Jussie, they're saying like, oh, the cops are working with these brothers.
What's the motive for the cops?
I have no idea.
Dude, the chief.
They're not fans of Empire, that's why.
The superintendent.
Oh, I forgot to mention too, a lot of people were saying that Jussie, or the people that are saying that he created this whole story before the cops charged Jussie, they were saying that he created this story because his part was about to be written off of Empire, and so he needed to create some controversy. But then Fox
There's said, so many motives working in his
Fox yeah. said that that's false, that he was never going to be written out, and that he's still working on the show.
Mm-hmm. Well, they just said today that that they're looking at all options. And then the police superintendent, this black guy, I just heard him on the radio. He just fucking excoriated the dude, man.
What does that mean?
He like fucking lit him up.
Okay.
He was just like, he faked this shit. He sent himself a fake letter. He did it all for his salary, apparently. He wanted to increase his own salary or some shit. This all just
came
out.
He wanted to be more relevant.
Fuck.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And he did. He is. That's, He's a household name now.
Yeah, but not for the right.
Not anymore. No.
And he literally threw his own people under the bus.
Jussie something?
That's what's crazy about it to me. The Chicago superintendent, the guy running the investigation, a black guy, he's out there saying this guy, like, we have the evidence and here's what the case is. You gotta watch the video of him because he just lays it out.
The funny thing is, like, he makes it seem like Chicago PD is, like, infiltrated by the KKK and it's all just white policemen.
Mm-hmm.
Like, right. Which is the stupidest thing I've ever heard. That's how he makes it off to seem like, they're out to get us, man.
Weren't the attackers, or the supposed attackers, black, though?
Yeah.
So, if the police were racist white people, wouldn't they want to keep those attackers in jail?
They're covering for these two black guys.
Yeah.
For some reason.
Exactly. Why would they protect these two black attackers if they're
These so two racist? Innocent black guys are saying that they're guilty of doing this. For some reason.
Conspiracy, I don't know.
See? It's pretty tough to defend the guy at this point.
We'll see what happens.
That is all kinds of fucked up, and he really just threw his own people
What the
under
shitty
the bus.
Thing is that it shits all over people who are really going through, like Bart said.
Yeah. Yep.
And it makes everyone look at all those things as like with like a skeptical eye
yep.
now.
Yeah. Because there was this incident that happened in the South, like I think in the 90s. This guy was walking down the street, and a group of guys basically tied him up. And then they tied him up to the back of a truck, and then they dragged him down the street up and down.
Oh my God.
Yeah, and I mean.
I remember that.
You can't hide the fact because his skin's all fucked up from all the road rash or whatever. but things like that actually can happen, but when they do, people might be like, really, did that really happen?
Mm-hmm.
Sure. Did you drag yourself from the truck?
Yeah.
Like Jesus.
Did you do this and like, you know, so you could cry wolf? I don't know.